Right, match one, game three, and man, looking at a bit of a stinker, I have to say, but I don't think I can chip it. I mean, as long as I keep drawing lands, it's got a first turn play, it's got a third turn play, it's got good cards. I've just got to hope for a good draw, that's all. Not worth mulliganing. Certainly my opponent's not got the fastest deck in Darksteel Sentinel. Is quite an asset against huge creatures. Snaps our glider, of course, for flyers. Not 3/3 flyers, but, you know. Drawing a 5-drop. Not really what I want, although it does fit into the curve. So as long as I keep drawing lands for the next couple of turns. Alright, that's a good start. In for one. So I've got, yeah. If I keep drawing lands now, up to 7, I should be looking in good stead, especially if Quicksilver Gargantuan copies a Flesh Eater Imp as a 7/7. Glisser the Traitor. Alrighty, so I guess Snap Sail Glider is all there is to it. Glisser the Traitor, hard one to kill. First Strike, Death Touch, bit hard to get around. Indestructible does do it, however. Alright, in for 3. I won't block this time. Keep my germ for when perhaps there may be an artifact in my opponent's graveyard or something. Alrighty, so I've got choices between Necropede or Flesh Eater Imp. I can play Necropede and equip the Snap Sail Glider. No, that's average. That's all kinds of average. I think I go with Flesh Eater Imp. Flesh Eater Imp and the Germ, I'll block Dross Ripper. Hopefully draw my 5th land and get Nestor Ghoul, which will be a good block for Dross Ripper. Get in. I'll send this germ south. Definitely not worth a double block here with Pump Mana up. I'm not terribly interested in killing Dross Ripper either with Glisser. Able to get through and return artifacts. Alrighty. That's not a problem. Okay, Flesh Eater Imp is not going to block, so he's going to get in. And we're going to run out Nestor Ghoul. What is this? What is this? I assume my opponent's going to kill my Flesh Eater Imp, which is, well, that's unfortunate, but alright, Wing Puncture. But seeing as how it wasn't going to be blocking anyways. Alrighty, Nestor Ghoul. So, I can go Nestor Ghoul on Dross Ripper and then Snap Sail Glider on Glisser, perhaps. Oh wait, no, Dross Ripper's not getting in, okay. In that case, I will take the 3, I guess. Yep. Another 3. Hopefully drawing one more land for Darksteel Sentinel. A Quicksilver Gargantuan that's indestructible would be pretty tasty. Okay. Beautiful. Pass turn. So, gonna take a bit of damage here, but gonna kill something good. Rotwolf I'm not concerned with taking damage for. Maybe I'll double block. Oh, nope. Gliss is not attacking. Alrighty. So, I'm gonna go Darksteel Sentinel. I'm gonna go Darksteel Sentinel and... let's see... double block Dross Ripper with Sentinel and a Zombie. So that way only a Zombie dies. I think that is acceptable. And I take 2 poison damage, which is not an issue at all. So, Quicksilver is a copy of any creature, so I can have a 7-7 Glisser, or a 7-7 Rotwolf, or a 7-7 Indestructible. So many options, so many amazing options. Or a 7-7 Flying with Metalcraft. Back around. Alpha Tyrannax, okay. So, no, that's not land. I think Necropede, perhaps? I mean, I can Blade Opinions my Darksteel Sentinel and get in for damage. 1, 2, 3, 4, and play Necropede as well. Or I can equip something. I guess a First Strike Necropede. Well, if it was a 2-2 first strike, I guess. Or I could have a 2-2 first striking Snap Cell Glider. Let's see, my opponent's not going to attack with Glissa, that's not very good. Seeing as how she activates as soon as I have creatures that die. Rotwolf. My opponent attacks with Rotwolf and Tyrannax. I could block. I'm gonna equip the Sentinel here and get in. Just banking on the fact that attacking with a Glisser is not a good play. That makes where the opinions should go a bit more simple. Okay, that's not good. That is not good. So, no attacks. I still can't play Snaps out. Quicksilver Gargantuan. That hurts. That really hurts. Alrighty. So, I'm going to attack with Sentinel. Alright, I'm going to play... if I Flare Husk Necropede and Bladed Pinions, I can block Glissa, but then which makes Glissa not attack, and Tyrannax will get in and I'll throw a Snap Cell Glider under it. Not good standing. I really need that 7th mana so I can get to Quicksilver Gargantuan. copy an artifact when it comes in, I guess. Copy Gliss of the Trader, and then maybe I'll be able to bring back Snap's Our Glider. Things like that. We'll see. Let's see how it plays out. I'm on the back foot, but one more land, it could be okay. What is this? Nope, changed his mind. Okay. Dross Ripper, sure. So, my opponent's looking to rush me by tapping down two creatures and finishing me off that way. Alright, that's... Well, I guess it helps, but not the card I was looking for. So, I play Snap's Our Glider. I could diversify here. Yeah. Go for the Throat is good, but I really wanted that 7th land. Right. Pass the turn, I guess. It's really unfortunate. I could have all these flyers. I could be attacking for 5, but I'm dying pretty hard on the backswing, so... Not a good plan. Though, Quicksilver Gargantuan, if he was a fly too, but we're not there yet. Yep, end of turn, tapping Sentinel. Okay, Necropede. And then in my turn, tapping Sentinel. Yep. And this hurts pretty hard. So I'm not worried about Rotwolf damage. What do I want to kill with Go for the Throat? I think with Go for the Throat I have to kill Glissa, because Glissa makes Quicksilver Gargantuan not work. And Quicksilver Gargantuan's all I've got, so I'm going to kill Glissa. And we're going to block Tyrannix. Do I have to block Dross Ripper as well? Let's see. 1, 3, 4. So 4, 1 makes 5. So I can, in fact, block Goldmere and only take the 4. I think that's what I'd rather do. Really need land number 7, and I think I'll copy Rotwolf. Ready? Down to 8. Another Tyrannax. What is this? Plague Maw, okay, that's fine. So, land and play Quicksilver Gargantuan, and it's going to be good. Okay, that is not Quicksilver Gargantuan. That is not even remotely helpful. Ah, dear. So, my opponent's turn, he can untap and then tap down one of my creatures, which means that I'll only get to block one, which means I'll take 1, 2, 3, 3, 1, 2, 3, so that's 5 and 4 makes 9, so yep, I am just dead. Wow, that was unexciting.